Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.8 in the module PERT and CPM. The topic for the discussion is crashing the network and calculating the critical, finding the critical path. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of the PERT network by crashing the activities. Crashing the network and the cost analysis. For any project, the cost is involved. Resources, time is involved. Resources, that directly involves cost. There are two types of cost in the project analysis. One is direct cost and indirect cost. The direct cost depends on the amount of resources required to complete the project within the stipulated time. If the time is reduced, more resources are required, which increases the direct cost. So the resources may be men, machine, material. So when you shorten, when you reduce the time required for completion of the project work by crashing, the amount of material required or amount of resources required will increase, so which will cause the increase in the direct cost. Indirect cost depends on the project duration. It is overhead expenses, indirect cost, and it increases when the duration increases. So normally by crashing the activity, we will be reducing the number of days of completion of the project work. So the direct cost will increase and the indirect cost will decrease. So if you look at the duration of the project work and the cost analysis, the total cost of the project is shown here. And the direct cost, when the duration decreases, the direct cost will increase. So duration, normal time, so this is the normal time, the duration, the direct cost is low and indirect cost is high. So the direct cost will increase when you reduce the duration, and the indirect cost will increase when the duration reduces. Actually, total duration of the project work, so the duration, when you reduce the duration, the indirect cost will decrease and direct cost will increase. So this is the total cost, and here we have the optimum cost. Now crashing the time beyond the crash time and extending the project duration beyond the normal time will have insignificant effect on the project cost. So there is normal time of executing the project work. So that is what we calculated earlier in the earliest expected time, and in the earlier problem in the previous lectures we discussed the calculated time is normal time. Now in the project we can crash, so there is a crashing time. We can reduce the timing of executing or conducting an activity to the crash time. When you reduce to the crash time, so the cost of the project will increase. The activities in the critical path are crashed one by one to achieve the optimum project duration and the cost. So activities in the critical path alone, non-critical activity, they are not crashed because it will have insignificant effect on the project cost and the project duration. The activity with the minimum value of cost slope is selected for the crashing. So if you have number of activities, we have to crash one by one. The choice is based on the cost slope. So we have to first identify the minimum value, cost slope with the minimum value. We have to crash the activity, then proceed further to find out the minimum project duration and the cost of the project work. The cost slope is given by delta C by delta T. Delta C is the CC minus NC, crash cost minus normal cost, divided by the delta T is the NT minus CT. NT is the normal time and the CT is the crash time. So C stands for crash, C stands for cost, CC, NC, NT and CT. So we take an example, and to understand the crashing of the network and to minimize the project duration. Example number 12, the data on normal time and normal cost and the crash time and the crash cost for your project work are given below. Indirect cost is rupees 70 per day. Draw the network, crash the activity systematically and find the optimum project duration, project completion time and the cost. So there are 6 activities in the network, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 5, 3 to 4 and 4 to 5. So 1 to 2, the normal time is 8 days and the cost is rupees 100. The crash time is 6 days. We can reduce by 6 days and the cost will be 200 rupees. For activity 1-3, the normal time is 4 days and the cost will be 150 rupees. And if you crash for the 2 days, the cost will increase to 350 rupees. For the activity 2-4, normal time is 2 days, the cost will be 50 rupees. When you crash to single day, the cost will be 90 rupees. The activity 2-5, the normal time is 10 days, the cost will be 100 rupees. If you crash to 50% of the time, 5 days, the cost will be 400 rupees. The activity 3-4, the normal time is 5 days and the cost will be 100 rupees. When you crash to 1 day, it will be 200 rupees. For the 4-5, the normal time is 3 days and the cost will be 80 rupees. When you crash to 1 day, the cost will be 100 rupees. Now the network diagram for the project and initial and the critical path is identified as 1-2-5. So the TE value, TL value, slack value, everything is calculated and we identified the critical path is 1, 2 and 2, 5. With the normal conventional calculation, we have to calculate TE and TL value and calculate the slack of the event, slack of the activity, critical path, critical activity and then critical path. The direct cost is sum of normal cost of all activity when executed normal time. So the normal time is 18 days. So the total cost equal to direct cost plus indirect cost. Direct cost is given as, so the sum of all these values is rupees 580 and the indirect cost is 18 days into 70 rupees per day. So this will be 1840. This is the total cost of the project work when we execute the project in the normal duration. Now we calculate the cost slope of each activity. So 1, 2, the table is repeated here. Delta T is calculated. Delta T is the NT minus CT. So 8 minus 6, 2, 4 minus 2, 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 10 minus 5, 5, 5 minus 1, 4, and 3 minus 1, 2. And delta C, 200 minus 100, 100, 350 minus 150, 200, 90 minus 50, 40, 400 minus 100, 300, 200 minus 100, 100, 100 minus 80, 20, and delta T by delta C by delta T, the values are 50, 100, 40, 60, 25, and 10. So in the critical path, there are activities 1, 2 and 2, 5. The lowest cost slope is 50 for the activity 1, 2. So crashing the activity 1, 2. The activity in the critical path are 1, 2 and 2, 5. Among the two activities, the activity with the low cost slope is 1, 2 with the cost slope of rupees 50. And the activity 1, 2 is crashed to 6 days. So this is the normal network. And it is crashed to 1, 2 is out of 8 days. Now it is reduced to 6 days. Now once again we calculate the project duration, the activity, the time for a various activity. And the TE, TL values are calculated again. And it is reported the time is reduced to 16 days. Again the critical path is 1, 2 and 2, 5. Now the direct cost. Direct cost is the total direct cost for the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity multiplied by cost slope of the crashed activity. So the direct cost of the previous network is rupees 580. Time saved 8 days is reduced to 6 days. The time saved is 2 days into 50 rupees is the cost slope. So this is cost will be 680 rupees. And the indirect cost is 16 days. Now the project is reduced to 16 days. 16 into rupees 70 equal to 1120. Now the total cost equal to 680 plus 1120 equal to rupees 1800. So the cost is reduced to 1800. Now again, next activity, next crashing the activity 2-5. So the next activity in the critical path is 2-5 with the cost slope of 60. The activity 2-5 is crashed to 5 days. So the activity instead of 10 days, 2-5 is 10 days here and it is reduced to 5 days. Now calculating once again TE value, TL value and identifying the critical path. Now the critical path is changed to 1, 3, 3, 4 and 3, 4, 5. So the critical path is changed. Now for the crashed network, the direct cost is total cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity multiplied by cost slope of the crashed activity. So this is equal to 680, the total direct cost of the previous activity, previous network is 680 plus 5 into 60 equal to rupees 980. And the indirect cost, now the time is reduced to 12 days, 12 into rupees 70 equal to 840, and the total cost is 980 plus 840 equal to rupees 1820. Now, in the critical path, there are three activities. So, among the three activities, now the lowest cost slope is 4-5 with the cost slope 10. The activity is 4-5 is reduced, crashed to 1 day. So, 4-5 is here. The number normal time is 3 days. Now, it is reduced to 1 day. Now, reducing to 1 day, again we calculate the TE and the TL value for each event. And now, the critical path once again changed to 1-2 and 2-5. So, the time, the project duration is reduced to 11 days. Now, the direct cost, the total cost of the total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity multiplied by the cost slope of the crashed activity. So, now here 980 is the direct cost of the previous network plus 2 into 10 equal to 1000. And the indirect cost is 11 days, 11 into 70 equal to rupees 770, and the total cost equal to 1000 plus 770 equal to 1770. Now, once again, this is the final network. Once again, the critical path is changed to 1-2 and 2-5. Now, these two activities already crashed. So, no more further crashing is possible. So, this is the final calculation. This is the final network where the cycle, the project duration is reduced to 11 days and the cost is reduced to 1770. And this is the table. So, for without crashing, the normal time is 18 days. Direct cost, indirect cost, 580 and 1260, total cost is 1840. When you crash the activity 1-2, the time is reduced to 16 days, direct cost increased to 680, indirect cost reduced to 1120, the cost is 1800. By crashing the activity 2-5, the total time is reduced to 12 days and the direct cost is increased to 980, indirect cost is 840 and the total cost is 1820. And by crashing the activity 4-5, the time is reduced to 11 days, direct cost is 1000 rupees, indirect cost is 770, and the cost of the total cost of the project work is 1770. So, this is how we have to crash the activity in the critical path step by step and calculate the minimum project duration and the cost required to complete the project work. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find operation research. You can refer to the book for additional information on the PERT CPM, particularly crashing the network. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. We will meet again with another example on the crashing the network. Until then, bye.